Now we start for this lecture on jar for ideologies, meaning that I try to, and we try actually, because there will be some other instructors, and Nicolò and Michele in practice. And what we want to do is to give you a way to start with Java, but focusing on the typical problem that we have. So actually, for starting, often programming is an activity that people or like extremely or do not like. So in any case, either if you like or you don't like, it's better that you learn it. And then in case you eventually make someone other to program and write your problem. And this first part is just a brief part introduction on some tools to use. Traditional in courses, let's say even in informatics or in computer science, they start from Java, from the command line. But that's not anymore the way that we use Java or any other program. We use an ID, meaning an interface to Java. In particular, we will use Eclipse. So I already asked you to install Eclipse this morning on the other things. And we don't care anymore to why using or not using an ID. In a professional world, you have to use an ID, because the tools that have an ID, are so many and help you in managing complex program. We will do a very simple program, but a complex program needs to be managed by, and you need an ID. Then we realize that an ID is not enough. For learning Java, I did a post where I made a list of books about Java. And here you have at least two classical books. One is Bruce Ekel, and the other is David J. Economic, the name quite similar, where they introduce Java. I have to warn you that this is quite a traditional way to approach Java. Java evolved a lot, especially from version 8, where lambdas, calculus, and functional programming was introduced. Before that, there was during the various version of Java, there were introduced several things like collections, for instance, or in Java 5, I believe. In any case, here you have quite a traditional list of books learning what is Java programming. I would say that Java is a language in the family of C programming. And why Java? Because first I started with C. And then I was looking for an object-oriented programming way. And the choices were C++, which kind was, is not, in my opinion, is very useful, is a good language, is powerful, but they grow so much complicated. And I prefer Java is more purely object-oriented, even if people in computer science will say that it's not fully object-oriented. And about why to use object-oriented languages instead of other languages, like procedural languages or functional languages, but Java is also functional language. I hope to be able to show to you some, to give some hints why I choose an object-oriented programming tool. At the beginning, my choice for C was because C was the language in which was quite a low level type of language. You could program also the operating systems in C. And at that time, when I started, Fortran didn't have dynamic memory allocation. Why C had the dynamic memory allocation? So for me, treating matrices and vectors was important. I have to, with Fortran, I had to give a specific length of a matrix or a list, so wasting a lot of time, a lot of space, not of time. And so I decided for C, and I learned C, and then going to Java was quite a natural choice. For what for Eclipse, there are these pages by Vogel. They are very well made. So if you want to learn the fundamental of Eclipse, you better go and give a look to these sites. It's not only they are good because they are clear, but they are also relatively short. So or subdivided in short tasks. So if you go there, you don't have to read a book of 1,000 pages for learning to use it. So it's very effective also. Obviously, programming is a thing that unfortunately I cannot do very much. It's about practicing many times. Reading a book about programming is a nice thing. So you get accustomed to some concept like object-oriented programming by various types of ways of documenting the systems, about tools and so, but at the end you have to program and develop your own styles also of programming, because usually there will be several ways to do a thing. So the scope of this class is also to introduce you a little bit also on software engineering. How, for instance, subdivide a code in parts. Why subdivide a code in parts? How, or which is the abstraction that we have to use in code, depending on what we have to do. And obviously there will be also pass on tools like Git, like Gradle for managing the whole stuff. Here I mentioned a few. Git is a repository. A repository is a place where you put your code and you manage the version of your code. When I started, I am so old that there were no repository for your code. So you have 200 versions of your code in your computer, and then you go to do another job or another task for a few weeks, and then you didn't remember which was the right code. That is not a way to go. So these version control systems help you to maintain the control of what the modification you did in the past. And you can also recover previous versions of your work. So it's another necessary tool for your programming activity. And Maven and Gradle are another important things, which is you need building tools. When you program, then you have to compile your code, in particular also in Java, you have to compile to the bytecode of the Java virtual machine, not exactly to a computer hardware. But you can build this code through various tools. If your tools are simple, you simply can digitize a command on the command line, for instance. We will not do because we are using Eclipse, but and this seems simple.
Then you realize, for instance, that you have to work with another programmer, and the other programmer uses an ID different from yours. For instance, IntelliJ, which is another ID system. Okay. For instance, Francesco uses IntelliJ. And Eclipse and IntelliJ have different way to organize the code inside their own hierarchy of routines and things. And so if you write a project in Eclipse, you cannot immediately transport it to IntelliJ or to NetBeans, which is the first ID of Java. Because NetBeans is the Oracle now, and the Sun at that time ID of Java. So you can use a building system. AMP, Maven, and Gradle are three building systems where you specify to a file which are the dependencies that you have or you want to use, and the type of a subroutine that you have to connect together at the moment of building, the libraries where that you go to take, and let's say that they are three good tools, but in our group we use Gradle. And so probably there will be also a couple of lectures on the beginning in Gradle for beginners. And in any case, I have a book for each one of these tools, and I will share with you. So that's the starting point of our